Hey everyone, it's Susan Jones and welcome back to my channel. We are now well into December and I don't know about you, but when I was in the classroom, I loved teaching about holidays around the world. Now I didn't do a big long, you know, month long unit where we would do passports and crafts and taste food, which don't get me wrong, sounds amazing. I just never had the time to do that. Instead, about a week before the holiday break, I would go ahead and introduce about 7 different holidays from around the world that were generally celebrated in late fall and winter, mostly winter, just Diwali is celebrated in October or November, so we talked about that one too. And we would read passages about them that were written in kid-friendly language, we would talk about vocabulary and comprehension, and we would definitely compare and contrast the holidays. It is just a great way to get your students learning about other cultures and recognizing that their holidays and their celebrations, while are very important, aren't the only ones that are in the world. So recognizing that so many of you are digital this year, I wanted to go ahead and share a little freebie that I made for you available in Seesaw and Google. And I wanna share some of the best videos, books, or read alouds that you can find on the internet to teach your kids about these holidays. Let's dive in. Okay, so first things first, I do want to let you know that a few years ago, I created a relatively inexpensive product over on TPT. It looks like this. It's only $3, and inside it, I go through 7 different holidays, and I wrote out a passage about them written in kid-friendly terms. It's definitely geared towards kindergarten, first, and second grade. Think second graders can definitely read it themselves. Kindergarten, you would read it with them and discuss with them. And then each of the 7 holidays also has a vocabulary sheet where we talk about some of the important terms related to the holiday. And it has a comprehension sheet where students need to share their learning and make some connections and compare the holidays that they're learning about. And the 7 holidays included in that unit are Christmas in America, Christmas in Italy, and Christmas in Germany. And then we also talk about Las Posadas, we talk about Diwali, Hanukkah, and what's the last one? Kwanzaa. So those are the 7 that we talk about in that unit. And it is a PDF, so you can naturally just upload the different passages you want to teach into Google or Seesaw if you are teaching virtually. And I show you how to do that in these videos right here, Seesaw, Google. So if you need help, go there. But I also wanted to share some free videos and read alouds that you can find online and a few books to go with each of those holidays in case you don't own that unit. Now, since so many of you are teaching virtually, I wanted to go ahead and create a little freebie that makes it easy for you to still share all this information with your students. So in the next couple portions of the video, first I'm gonna show you a screen share of the freebie that I made for you and kind of how it works in both Seesaw and Google. That's only gonna be a few minutes, so stay tuned for that. And then after that, I'm going to share for each of those 7 holidays I listed earlier, I'm gonna share a quick book or a quick link that you can either read aloud yourself or find a read aloud on YouTube to give a little bit more information about each of the holidays to your students. I figured this would be a fun way to still get your students learning about those different cultures and those holidays, even if you aren't with them in person. So let me show you the freebie I have for you. So here's the freebie I have for you guys. This is it in Seesaw, but it's basically exactly the same in Google Classroom. And as you can see, all 7 of the holidays that I teach about are here, and they are all linked to a page within this document. So Christmas in Italy, if they click on the link, they get brought to their recording sheet. So I mentioned this prior, but this freebie doesn't have the information for each of these holidays, but in the next segment of this video, I'm actually going to share with you tons of read alouds on YouTube, book suggestions, and other kid-friendly videos for students to learn about any of these holidays. But this is where they can record their findings. And if you wanted to use my close reading passages, you could also go ahead and have students read those and then record here in Seesaw or Google. So basically, let's say they read about Kwanzaa, they would go ahead and click on page 5. Here they could type a few facts that they learned, and then I left this box blank for them to draw a picture of something they learned about the holiday. And when they're done, they go up here, they can drag using the star or using the move tool, they can drag a star over Kwanzaa. So if you were doing one a day or a couple a day, they can kind of keep track of the ones they've already completed
And again, they can do this kind of on their own, or you can give them specific date holidays to do each day. That's up to you. I also went ahead. Oh, and just so you know, you can't see it here, but up here where I'm clicking in the student version, I'm sure you're familiar with this, but it has a orange check for draft. So if my students are ever doing something that takes longer than a couple days, I have them press draft instead of publish. That way it kind of saves the progress that they've done. So they can just come back to it and they'll only do publish when they are officially complete. That's in a Seesaw, and Google it just saves it wherever it is. Last but not least, on the last page here, I have a let's compare sheet so they can pick two holidays. You can pick for them or you can have them choose. They could type it in and then share how the holidays are alike and how they are different. Now, one last thing I do want to share is if you decided, and this will be similar in Google, but if you decided you only want to do five holidays or you don't want to teach about Christmas in Italy, let's say, all you have to do is this. Let me just show you. You're going to click it and you're just going to delete. All of these are movable, so you can reformat it. Let's say you wanted to delete Christmas in Italy. So we deleted that, and now you just have to delete that page too. You could leave it here because actually these are already linked, so it doesn't matter. But you would also, if you wanted to, delete that page just like that. Now, the only thing is, oh wait, I did it. I was going to say I wanted to make sure that this still links up, and they do. So Christmas in America is now page 6. And it still links there. So you can kind of customize it that way too.
Okay, so now that you saw that freebie for students to go ahead and record what they've learned, how are you going to teach them what they've learned? If you don't want to use something like my unit that I've already made, then I have a few ideas for each of these holidays. I'm going to run through them pretty quickly because I'm going to link them all in the description down below. So if you're interested in either getting that book or finding the links to those YouTube videos, just look down there after this video. The first two resources I'm going to share are going to be for Christmas in Italy and for Las Posadas, and that is because Tommy DiPaola makes fantastic books. He is just a literary genius, as if you're a K-2 teacher, I'm sure you already know, but two of his books are great for using during this time. So the first one is The Night of Las Posadas, which obviously would be for that holiday. And that is a great book to read. I have it linked down in the description, and I also have a read aloud of it that will also work great. And just FYI, I did watch all of the read alouds from YouTube that I'm linking down in the description, and I believe they are student friendly. You still want to watch it yourself? I totally get it, but I do want to let you know that I kind of vetted them out first. And the other one to read is La Befana, which talks about the little witch who lives in Italy who might be visiting your house during Christmas time. For teaching students about Hanukkah, I like this book right here, which is called The Story of Hanukkah by David A. Adler. And I will have both the book and a student-appropriate read-aloud shared for you down in the description for this one as well. Now, for Christmas in Germany, it was hard to find a book that really went into all the details about Christmas in Germany and some of their traditions, but I found this video that looks like this, and this video is a woman from Germany, and she is in the German markets, and she kind of gives you a little sneak peek about what it's like to be in the German markets during Christmas time, and it's just a cool way for students to kind of step into that German culture. It's only 4 minutes long too, so it's not too in-depth, and the students will learn a lot while they watch it. Teaching about Kwanzaa, I found two different resources that I really like. The first one is this book right here, My First Kwanzaa by Karen Katz. It's a pretty easy read and goes over many of the traditions when celebrating Kwanzaa, and you can find a bunch of read-alouds of it on YouTube. But there is also an old Sesame Street video that is just fantastic. It's from 2008, so it is pretty old, but it's on YouTube and it's been streamed over 1 million times. And I will put that right here and insert that in the description down below, so you can get that link as well. I particularly like the Sesame Street video because it shows a real family who actually celebrates Kwanzaa, and they get to explain what their traditions are like. Now, for teaching about Diwali, one of my favorite books is this one right here. It is called Binny's Diwali, and I like this book because it's about a little girl who gets to go to her class and share about her holiday that she celebrates. So it kind of comes from the voice of another child, and the students in your class may be able to relate or better understand her experiences. All right, last but not least, I have Christmas in America, and I'll be honest, I searched kind of high and low for a great book that's just about Christmas. There are many Christmas books, where we have like turkey claws and we have things about moose and reindeer and Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer, but I couldn't find a great kids book that teaches just about like the meaning of Christmas and what people, like the different ways people celebrate. So in my passage from the unit that I shared about at the beginning of this video, I explain at the beginning of the passage how the holiday originated from the birth of Jesus Christ and how many people over the years have celebrated it, even if they don't necessarily have religious ties to it. And I share just the different ways we now see people in America celebrating. Also in that passage, we talk about the belief of Santa Claus coming to visit and bring us some gifts. We talk about giving back during the holidays and how people like to donate and help others in need. We talk about writing letters to Santa Claus and all the things that we do here in America. So if you have a great book, please leave it down in the description down below so I can check it out. I couldn't find one that kind of wrapped everything up nice and concisely for me to read to my students. But that doesn't mean there isn't one out there. That just means I couldn't find it right now. So please help me out. Drop it down in the comments. All right, there are a bunch of resources for all seven of those holidays, and using that free kind of organizer where students can click on the holiday and share their learning, I think you'll be able to create a fun and virtual holiday celebration for your students to learn about all different cultures, get excited about the holidays coming up, and learn to appreciate others and themselves. As always, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please give me a thumbs up so I know. Make sure you are subscribed to my channel, and I will see you in a few days. Bye.